This screencast is going to show you how you can perform string searches using VBA. So I wanted to just sort of introduce this. We wish to search through the following array in Excel for a specified string and display the row and column indexes for the first match encountered. So we've got 9 here. We could easily go through many more cells than this, but maybe we wish to search through the array for O-log, O-L-O-G. And this is found in cell C2 within the word geology. And that's going to be row 2, column 3. And so we want this VBA subroutine to tell us where we find the first match for the string. The approach is to first determine the search string length. And we can use the LEN function in VBA. It tells us the length of a certain string. So if the user types in O-log, O-L-O-G, then the length is 4. In each of our cells, in our example, we have A1 through C3. We're going to iterate through in sets of the search string length. In our example, it's 4. So we're going to start with the first 4 letters to see if there's a match. Then we're going to go to letters 2 through 5 to see if there's a match. Then 3 through 6, and so on. If there's a match, then we're going to display the row and column indexes. If no match, we're going to tell the user that there are no matches. So let's look at one example. And again, our search string is O-log. We're going to look at the first cell, A1, which is computing. The first iteration, again, we're looking in sets of 4 letters. So does comp equals O-log? No. Does ompu equal O-log? No. And if we went through all the different possibilities, there are no matches for this word. So we move on to the next cell and we keep going until finally we get to geology. Does geol equal O-log? No. So we move on. We go E-O-L-O. Does that equal O-log? No. Finally, we move on to the match and we see that O-log equals O-log. So at this point, we are going to want to display to the user Your string has been found in, you know, row 2, column 3. So I've already set this up in VBA, so I'm going to show you how it operates, and then I'm going to show you the code for it and go over the kind of highlight some of the important things about the code. When we run the search, the user can put in a string, O-log, for example, and this is going to then ask for a range to search through, and we can highlight this selection, the range that we want to search through, and then they click OK, and it says your string was found in row 2 and column 3. So that's in geology, okay? And if, let's say, I put in something that wasn't in there, let's just say something like help, I'm going to search through that range. It says your string was not found. So let me show you the code for this. Go into the editor here. I dim a bunch of different things. STR is our string that the user inputs. Size is going to correspond to the length of that string. We also have 2 strings here and there, which I will highlight in a moment. We have a user range that's dimmed as a range. That allows the user to sort of highlight a range that we're going to search through. Default range is something else, and that's a string. That's just the default range that comes up when that box pops up. We have N rows and columns, so that's a number of rows and columns in our selection. I and J are going to be, and K are going to all 3 be indices that we iterate over in 4 next loops. And then once we get to the particular cell that has our match, we're going to record the row index of that cell and the column index. So those are 2 other things we have to dim. So the first part is to have an input box, and the user inputs the string that they are searching for, and that's stored in str. We have our default range, which is where the cursor lies, what selection we have selected when we run the sub, and that's just sort of the default range. And now we have this user range. We have an application input box. We're using an input box method where we have a prompt range to search. We have a title, so we're searching. And then the default, so when this input box is opened, we have a default, and that's just our default range, which we assigned earlier. And then whatever they put into that box, so they highlight it, A1 through C3 in our example, that's going to be selected, so that's going to be our selection. And then we go through some more lines here where size is the length of the original string. So if they typed in OLOG, the length is 4. We have N rows and N columns, which is the number of rows and columns of our selection, which is what they selected, A1 through C3. And now we're going to iterate through all rows and columns. So we have an index I for all the rows. We have an index J for all the columns. I and J are nested. J is nested within I. We're going to have a fixed row index, for example, row 1. And while I is constant at 1, we're going to go through all three columns, or however many columns you have. So we're iterating through the different columns of row, and then we bump down to the second row, iterate through all columns of the second row, and so on. When we are in each of those cells, or combinations of I and J, we have yet another for next loop, and this is what will iterate through the strings to see if there's a match. So we're going to start with k equals 1. That's the starting character of our string that's in each cell. So we're going to go from that to the length of the selection that we're currently on. So if we have the word computing, the length of that is, so we're going to go from k from 1 to the length of that. And now we're saying we're going to use the mid function in VBA. What that does is we can chop out more or less different fragments in our string. So for example, computing is our string. Then we can use different combinations of K, and depending upon the size, remember size was the length of our original string, and we're checking if that fragment of length that matches our search string is equal to the string, then we want to record the row index and we want to record the column index. And I just kind of have a pseudo way to exit out of all these for loops in case we're pretty much done searching. We found our match and we're going to exit. This doesn't allow us to find multiple matches, but it does find the first match. And then we have a go to here. The here bumps us way out down here. And then we have message box, your string was found in row whatever and column whatever. Now, if there was no match found, it goes through all the different values of I, J, and K. Then we want to say message box, your string was not found. So it'll display a message box. We don't want it to display this second message box line because we didn't find it. So what I've done is have this little go to there, which bumps us over the here statements, okay, to there, and then we exit, we end the sub. So let's go through this. I'm going to step through this. F8, string, what string are you searching for? OLOG, press enter. F8, range to search. I'm going to go back over here. And that was my default range because I already had that selected, so that's what shows up here. So I'm going to search through that, pressing F8. The size is 4, right? OLOG is length 4. Number of rows should be 3. Number of columns is 3. So down here in our locals window, we see that they're both 3. And now we're going to iterate through all the different combinations. And we're checking to see if different strings match our search string. We know that geology is found when I equals 2 and J equals 3. So let me move this locals window up a little bit. Right now we're on I is 1 and J is 3, so we want to go quite a bit longer. We found our match. We set the row index to be 2 down here. The column index is 3 because that's what corresponds to the I and J that we are currently at. And then we exit out to here, message box, your string was found in row 2, column 3. That's how we can search through a bunch of strings in an array to see if we can find a match.